Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with finally a look at the UNSC Elephant from the Mega Bloks Halo series, a 2011 release, now definitely discontinued. Came with 1,273 pieces. Let's take a look at the components. First, of course, we'll focus on the elephant itself and look at some of the things it comes with. Big ol' thing, and it does have the crane on the side, so since that's facing us, we'll just take a look at that. It turns around. It's actually able to extend out and in, and it has a little winch on it, so if you turn around to this side, you can see a little knob that you can turn up and down, and that's actually has a little bit of mechanical advantage on it. Allows you to bring this little hook down. And they do have a couple of little cargo crates included with this set, so I'll just bring a couple of those back in, and you can grab those with this and actually load them up onto the thing. It takes a little while to wind this up, like I said, because of that mechanical advantage, but it actually does look really good because they did that. Things do kind of get in the way a little bit with the machine gun up here in the corner, the little turret. Kind of have to bring this in, and you can see how that actually touched there. So that's a little bit off and a little bit unfortunate, but this allows you to then bring your cargo all the way inboard. So it looks proper, it just kind of gets in the way a little bit. That's just part of the problem of trying to scale things down and make them fit into a reasonable size with the size of studs and everything, you know, minifigures and all. The tracks down here are very nice. These are real rubber and they're very soft, and they do turn, they actually do spin, and let me just get this turned up so you can really see the detail of that. Very nice tread design on there. Very, very, very nice tread design on there. I really appreciate that, and some extra detailing on the sides here. The, you know, just getting some texture in there. Got a couple of pieces of spare treads on the sides. These are not actually swappable parts. You can't actually take apart these treads because they're single rubber belts, but that's just a nice little accurate thing. While we're looking at the sides, you can see there are quite a number of stickers used on this thing, quite a number. So if you hate stickers, you might want to just be, you know, be thoughtful about what things are really important to get the look of this thing across. Fortunately, it uses this camo design, which is mixed with a couple of really contrasting colors, especially with the green and the dark red that's in there. So it actually gets a good amount of texture, and with some of that light color, without even having any of these stickers on there. So I appreciate that. Got a few tools on the side. You've got shovels and picks. I'll turn around to the other side. And over here you can see you've got a jerry can and a big old axe, another one, pick. This is a little backpack for minifigs. They also have a couple spots for holding stuff on the front, another backpack here, another jerry can here. That's just extra stuff. It's really added on just to have, again, more detail. Of course, you've got a second gun. Both of the guns, unfortunately, are built exactly the same. They should be slightly different designs, but I think it still looks fine, and they work just fine putting a minifigure on there. Still do have a little bit of trouble with the range of motion with these things getting in the way. Even on this side where you don't have the crane in the way, your figure is going to stand right up against that, and he's going to hit the side of this. So you kind of have to pre-pose him a little bit and just stick to this kind of range out here. Also, you see over here on the side, the ammo can is hitting this upright little assembly over here. So few things getting in the way. Looking at this from the back now, I have to angle it up a little bit so you can see down in there. Wow, quite a large open space. And down at the other end, you've got a readout, a transparent, it's kind of a liquid crystal sort of display with the transparent piece and a sticker over it that gives you a kind of a heads up console. And that's a really, really nice piece. You can see right through it. It has some good color, has some good detail, shows, you know, different things that you can adjust. It's also showing a map, like a topographical map in there. So that's a really nice piece that I really appreciate. And there's lots of room in here. Over here on the side, it's a little bit in the shade, hard to get light in there, but you've got a whole rack of tools. Let me see if I can brighten this up so you can see down in there. Brighten everything up there, that's a little bit better, yeah? A whole rack of tools, including one power tool and a whole bunch of hand tools, even a crowbar. These are all different. I like that. I like all the different stuff that they give you here. I really appreciate that, because you can use those in all sorts of different scenarios, even outside of the Halo universe. You know, those will work with any Mega Bloks minifigures. So that, you know, that's just good extra stuff that you can use all sorts of places. Now, with this whole open space here, you do have a ramp at the back. The set does include a mongoose, which I will show you later, but you can easily fit multiple mongoose in there. This one can actually be driven through if you don't have a figure on there. If you do have a figure, it's not going to be able to drive all the way through, but there's so much space. You can easily put two mongoose side by side here. You can also put one in the front compartment. There's so much space. I'm going to bring in something that was not included with this set. You can put a warthog in there. Awesome. Very nice. And still with room to spare. And in addition to that, you can still put a mongoose and another in the front section. Let's look at that front section. So here you can see that from the side. You would probably have some sort of engineer sort of figure standing up against that console, but if he's on the opposite side, then you can still drive a mongoose in here. And I'm just going to bring in another mongoose that's not included with the set, just to show you how they do fit side by side easily with still room to spare. You could probably still fit a figure between them if you wanted to show one coming out. There is no ramp in the front. This whole front section does not come down. So if you want to drive these out, you have to imagine them kind of, you know, jumping off the end, which is just fine, but would have been nice to have a little ramp there. While we're looking at the front, up top, this is where your pilot would be, your driver. And this compartment does open up. This is actually a hatch. Just opens up like so. And looking at it from the other side, when you look down in there, you can see that there are a couple of little levers that you can activate. A figure does have to stand there. There's no actual seat, and it's pretty much just room for one single figure. And you don't have any console or anything like that, so a little bit lacking in the detail there. Here's a quick look at the one mongoose that is included in this set. This is a nice one. It's black with the transparent black windscreen, so very low key, but it's got some pretty bright stickers on there with the kind of caution construction sort of pattern. But there is weathering, like detail of wear on those stickers, so that makes it look not too new, makes it look used. Lot of stickers on this. I think this is the largest number of stickers they've used on any. There's one other that they did exactly the same, but didn't have any more or less than this. And the stickers really add a lot of realism to it and believability. It's a pretty simple build, but the good thing about these builds is that you can put one driver figure in and then put a rider on the back, because you have this three wide kind of little plate that you can put a second figure on. I showed earlier that you have a couple of little crates, and these open up and just give you some space to store some extra stuff. In this one, I put a couple of extra little backpacks that you can alternately or optionally use with your marine minifigures. And then this is just a little fuel cell right here, highly volatile, a good thing to shoot to make a big bang. Last but not least, let's look at the figures. So I've lined up just the Marines here. There's also a Spartan, but I'll look at him separately. Great thing going on here is that you have three different skin tones with these figures. So I really appreciate that, because I appreciate having a variety of different races represented in toys in general. You know, so that's a good thing. Not a whole lot of variety across the pieces used here. So you can see the torso is exactly the same here, here, and here, but it is a good one. So I'll just zoom in on one of those so you can see it more closely. Number of different colors there. You've got a dark gunmetal gray used, and a really dark brown or reddish brown color in there. These figures here, the four on the left, all have the little microphone and a single eye heads up display. This is really great right here. The flamethrower, carryable flamethrower with the little shark emblem on the front. I really like that. And taking a look at the back of one of these figures, you can see that the torso is going to look exactly the same across all of them. All the ones that look the same in the front look the same in the back also. And as you just go down the line, you can see I put the backpacks on a couple of them. This one here at the end is the slightly different one. He does have the covered face, so more of a full helmet. and also a different torso. So we'll just get that to focus on him. There you can see that. And all of these have a little bit of a wash over them that seems to help keep them looking a little bit dirty, a little bit weathered. And the weapons that are included here, you've got a Magnum. This guy has a battle rifle. This one has an assault rifle. Here you've got another battle rifle, and then we already looked at that flamethrower. So I really like this assortment of Marines that they've included here. I'm not a big fan of the Marine figures normally, but when you put this many different ones in front of me, yeah, I appreciate that. And here's the Spartan, a black recon Spartan. He's got black and gunmetal gray colors used on him, and he also has that yellowish gold visor. This is a pretty good looking one. Anytime they go with the dark colors, it works out better than the bright ones. It's just easier to make these look more believable. And this guy is intended to be used with the Mongoose. One of the reasons I believe that the Mongoose is made dark in color also kind of goes with this guy. This is a pretty nice sculpt. I liked this one, and I like specifically this color scheme with him. Also has some dark silver accents in there. Even looks good from the back. I like the back of the shoulder. These little areas have some nice little details on them. And this guy just has an assault rifle on his back. I'll take that off so you can just see the middle of the torso a little bit better, as well as the back of the helmet. And there you go. So in summary, yeah, this is a really big set, obviously, and that's the best thing that it has going for it. It's pretty accurate and authentic to a little bit of a combination between game versions, a little bit more towards the Halo 3 version than the Halo Wars version, actually. And I like it. I mean, it is what it is, right? It's an elephant. There are a limited number of things that you can do with it as a toy, because you know, you're not going to be able to actually create troops from it. It does have a good amount of carrying capacity. I very much appreciate that. The scale is actually not too bad. It's not too far artificially scaled to work with the minifigs and to work within a reasonable size to be able to sell it for a reasonable price. So overall, yeah, pretty good. I mean, everybody likes really big sets. I think that this one has a lot more quantity than quality, though, and that's really not Megablocks' fault. It's just the fault of what the thing is itself. I really do like what they did with the minifigures, the range that they gave you there. The Mongoose is nice, and the ability to actually hold on to and carry around a couple of Mongeese and a Warthog if you want, if you've got one of your own, is great. So it works out pretty well. I'm pretty happy with it. Now I just need to find a place to put this big old thing. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed that, or at least got some information out of it. I will be doing many more videos to come, so be sure to stay tuned and watch for updates at the blog at JANGBRiCKS.com. Talk to you again soon.